Wow, that's a lot of ketchup. Listen, we go through at least one bottle a month.
Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Today we're going to my laundry room and I'm gonna show you how I've set up and organized my long-term prepper pantry there. I call it my extended pantry because it's on the same floor as my kitchen and my pantry that's there. So it's an extension of my pantry, so my extended pantry. And it's more of long-term preps. It's kind of like a store. I get from there to replenish my regular pantry. So let me show you what I've done.
From the kitchen, the guest bedroom is to the right, also the guest bathroom. In front of me is the door to the garage and my command center. And here to the left is the laundry room. I am grateful that I have a laundry room. I love stepping in versus a closet or a wall. So it's just one of the little luxuries that I have. And here to the left is where I found space, which is basically vertical space. So here's an overview. And then I'm going to go into detail what I have here, and then I'll be replenishing some things. The lighting isn't the best right now because the overhead lamp, I actually see two bulbs are out, but let's just go ahead and do this video. So here you see on this wall, I have an over the door shoe holder. And honestly, if I want more, I can also put it on this wall, but for now, it's a blank. Then that's my Get Well Sick card. I'll link the video. Two hampers for dark and light. And then I actually have space here on this floor where I used to have 5 gallon buckets stacked up. I think I had two stacked up, so at least 4 over here. And now what I've done with those buckets is I've put them in my long-term pantry that's up in the room upstairs, which I'll show you in a different video. So whether it's for your prepper pantry or just your pantry, a shoe holder is perfect for those spices like that, where, you know, they're like packets. So that's all my Indian food stuff. And then here I have back stock of dressings, and then I have syrups here. And so what I do here is I shop here after my regular pantry. So I do have this pretty stocked up, and these are regular things that we eat. Here's some pudding and jerky, both in the stick form and then in the, you know, like pieces form. Here I usually put cookies. So I think those are like the Debbie oatmeal cookies. This is empty for now, so I can fill that up. Then I have here granola bars. And the nice thing with having the granola bars here is that you saw earlier where the door to the garage is when we're stepping out and we need to grab something, it's right here. And more granola bars. So I definitely like Clif bars, and I try to get a variety. And so if you're using something like this, you can think of it like in categories, right? So here, this whole line could be all granola bars. Here, it could be all granola bars, or two of them granola bars, two of them cookies. Here you could see it's more of like the jerky line, although I'm putting there. And then these are more bottled stuff. So if you want to have more dressings, you could fill up this whole line. And then the next line would be syrups or things like that. And then up here, you could see it's all like the Indian food stuff. And also I wanted to note that you see these are the ones that you could see into, because those I want to be able to read more easily if they're covered and they're way up here. I'm not going to know what's in them unless I put a label on in front. And then here you can see they're sticking out a little bit, so I know what's in there. And then the same with the jerky and same with the bottles, you could see what's there, but it's covered enough. And then I just hook them up with nails and anchors to the wall. Before I get to this shelving unit, I wanted to show you back here is where I keep my cleaning brooms and stuff. And then I have another over the door shoe holder for other things. Example, for prepping, I do have stuff for sealing and, you know, jar sealing, some of the canning stuff. Sorry about the lighting here, and you'll probably see shadows. Okay, so I got this system, this Alpha system. It's a wonderful shelving system from the Container Store. And I told the guy that this is what I'm gonna put on the wall, like this high. And he said, it'll be totally fine. And I'm like, no, I'm going to have canned goods and it's going to be heavy. And he's like, no, it will be completely fine. And I believe I've had this for 2 years, possibly three. I don't remember, actually. I mean, I could look it up, but I had put this up when I really got into stocking up. And so I absolutely love it. So if you want your laundry room, you know, to look all pristine and whatever, and this is all you want, and you want the space, well, then this isn't going to work for you. But if you really want to find a place to organize your preps, definitely think vertical. Look at those. See, when I'm standing here, okay, in front of my laundry. Now, it's not going to be the easiest in front, but I load my washer here from the side, so I have plenty of room. And then I load my dryer from this side and I have plenty of room. I don't, sometimes I fold my clothes here, but I usually bring them up or bring them to the couch, bring them to my bed, and I fold there. So I don't necessarily need space walking around in here. And then there's just enough space for my get well cart that I can tuck it in there when the times when we don't need it. And then here there's space even for my vacuum to hang on the wall. So I'm showing you that for you to think and, you know, look at your space and see what's going to fit, if the vertical space is going to work out for you. And you see here I used all the vertical space, the one for the brooms, behind the door. So I think let's start from the bottom. Another thing was I planned, as far as where I was going to put the shelves, is to have a space underneath, and that's where I hold the laundry baskets. Oh, I see a missing thing here. I'll just leave that. But here I have my canning supplies and my dehydrator, and I have this binder that I put together. I have another video for that. I'll link that. Okay, and then with the Alpha system, these are the ones where it's specifically for canned goods, and you can pull them out like that and then push it back in. So this one is seafood. Same, this is a pull-out drawer, specifically open. You know, you could see, I mean, you could put spices, you could put whatever. And this is for meat. And then this is more meat. Same thing, you could pull it out. And then these are shelves. And the other thing with this system, if you're going to look for a system, look for something where the shelves are adjustable. So you can see here, I can adjust according to the height of the basket or how tall you're going to stack things. Like here, the milk cartons are a certain height, you know, cans are a certain height. I doubled them here. Here you're going to see mayo and relish. That's a different height. That's why I highly suggest you get one with adjustable shelves. Then here I've used, these are baskets, and I like them. They're the sturdy ones from Target. These are also from Target. They're just labels. And I, instead of putting paper and messing with the paper and cutting it and all that, I just put the label directly onto the metal label holder. So here, milk. This one is condiments, ketchup, mayo, relish. And these are ones that we always use. Okay, here is peanut butter. So I did crunchy and smooth. So this is not like stuff we're going to eat all of this in 1 month, right? This is the prepper pantry, not just the extended pantry, but I just call it the extended pantry. Here are pickles and jams and jellies. And up there, I'll get a ladder later, but that's boxed rice, boxed sides, mac and cheese. And then up there are cookies, crackers, and cheese. And I'm sorry, yes, I love canned or spray cheese, sorry. All right, so sometimes I stock up one by one. Sometimes I do a bigger stock up. So here I'm, when I have a little bit bigger stock up, I go ahead and I put towels on top of these because that's where I'm gonna put the products. And then I'm gonna put them onto the shelves. Okay, so for this stock up, you can see that I got stuff from Amazon. So this is also Amazon. I also get from Walmart, which is great because you can order online and they put it right in your trunk when it's ready to be picked up. And then, of course, there's Costco or bulk food items, stores like that, or your regular grocery store. So one thing I'll just point out, example with ketchup. We love ketchup. And the bulk size of ketchup in Costco is just way too big as far as fitting it onto the shelf. So I found this size, which is the 32 ounce, that fits perfectly on that shelf with everything else that I have on there. So that's something to think about. It's not a big deal. You can always lay it flat. Then aside from dry milk, which I have, or powdered milk, which I have in buckets, I have these type of Tetra Pak milk. And same thing goes for the mayo, you know, just having the right size container that will fit on my shelves is important to me. Here is some of the canned meat, and I found that, you know, Walmart definitely has good prices. What you wanna do, example, the ketchup, that's the exact same prices at Walmart as it is on Amazon. And so I just have a little running list of how much things are. And if it's going to be more on Amazon, then I'll just go ahead and get it at Walmart. But if it's the exact same price, I just buy from Amazon because they deliver to my door. Okay, I haven't dusted in a while, but you can see here that I also put dates on the top with permanent marker. It's easier to see. For example, if you have boxes, you could put them here. Let me know in the comments below what's your take on Best Buy dates. I definitely have used past Best Buy and it's completely fine. Okay, so for this shelf, seafood, I think I'm already stocked up. I might have gotten one more anchovies here. Let me see. I took the stuff out of the bags and laid them out so I can see them better. And so yes, I do have anchovies and I actually have two of them. So, of course, definitely put the price. So if you don't want to put the price, don't, not the price. If you don't want to put the date, don't put the date. It's up to you. Okay. So you can see one fits there and it goes in so nicely. All right. So for this shelf, you can see I have a couple deviled ham. I'm missing some Spam and then corned beef. So what I do is I get from the left. So I just go ahead and bring these over. Okay. And then I will put the new ones here. All right. And then this one is different. This is white meat. I think I wanted to just try that. And then as far as the Spam, so these are the last ones. So I go ahead and put it here. And then you notice that I put one up, down, up, down, up, down. Okay. All right. One, I think three fits here. Oh, I hope so. Okay, there. And then I think I could just put an extra one here. See, and it still fits. All right, next, corned beef. So same, I think I pushed this over already, but again, left to right. Okay, up, down, up, down. So you can have it like that, or if you don't want the label showing that way, you could do it this way. Okay, there you go. And then this is all good. Okay, so now for the milk, I just bring this forward. Okay. And then I put the other milk in the back. All right, so sometimes I do it that way and just like fit it in, or I just take this whole thing and put it on top of the dryer. Okay, I put the whole bin here, move this stuff forward. Okay, I took them out of the box. That would be easier. This is one-handed. I also sometimes get milk from the Dollar Tree. These are from Walmart, but my husband requested different milk, so he likes this brand, Califia, I think. Okay, there, you can see that all fits. Okay, it's all full again. And then these are coconut milk, evaporated milk. So it's still full. I could add more. All right, ketchup is empty, so let's fill that up. Okay, so just put that one up in front. And I think these are pretty much the same dates. So here I go front, back to the same row. Then I start here, back. Okay. If you're wondering, wow, that's a lot of ketchup. Listen, we go through at least one bottle a month. Okay. Sometimes every 3 weeks. So this is at least a year's worth. Okay. And you see how great it is to just have to stock up and do this, you know, not take up a lot of your time. Okay. I think this works because I think the bottle we have right now is almost finished. So I'll take one of those. Okay. So usually I have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 11. I usually have 12 in here. It's kind of how I remember how many this fits. See? Okay. See, it fits 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. Oh, that's 13. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and use this for the one we'll be using now. Okay, I put the ketchup back. You can see it's all full. Love it. And now I'm going to stock up this mayo and relish. I was making a recipe and I didn't have any mustard because we really don't like mustard. So I decided I'm going to also make this my mustard bin, and I'll just put it over here. And the mayo, I do need probably one more relish. Okay. And then this is one we're going to use now. So you can see I could fit two more bottles of relish and one more mustard. And that's how it's stocked up for now. All right, looks good. This is a three-step ladder that I keep in my garage, and this is what I use to access the stuff up here. I used to have the ladder here on this wall, which fits perfectly, but I put it with the other ladder in the garage, and plus it allowed me to be able to access the vacuum easier. Okay, so this is what it looks like up here. Here is the peanut butter crunchy and smooth. And I have some peanut butter here that is sun butter because for those with nut allergies in my family. And yeah, it's pretty stocked up in there. I'll need two hands to push this back in. And then here we have pickles and peppers. Like capers, pickles, the hot peppers, the pepperoncini, things like that. Always like to have those handy. Okay, jams and jellies. So I like a lot of jam. So strawberry, and same thing. How do you feel about still using these? I still use them. I think I have different ones like raspberry or berries, grape. I don't have a lot of grape in there. A lot of strawberry though. Okay, so I was thinking about, I think what happened here was that I was using this brand, the grocery brand of jams and jellies, and then I saw these, which fit much nicer in my fridge, because when I use it, I refrigerate it. So I bought a bunch of these, and I prefer this, so I started eating those more, and probably forgot about this or just ignored it, but I have to use this now. These bins are amazing. They're from the Container Store. I use them in my freezer organization, so I'll link that video. You can use them in the garage, in your craft room, in your office. It's fantastic. It's an open tote, and I like it because from, you know, standing down on the floor, it's easier to see this. I'd rather have this. You can have it covered and then just put a label. I've done both, but this is just easier for me. And it's inexpensive. It's a good price. It's very durable, and they come in different sizes. So you can see here, the box rice is full, so I didn't need to replenish that. The box sides, you know, I think I don't use this that often, so I don't try to stock it up so much. Then we have mac and cheese, and I make my own mac and cheese, but this is for if my daughter has friends and they want to make something quickly, then this is good for them. Oh, you don't know how much this has saved me having cookies here. So I have here Nutter butter, ice cream cones. So I try to stock up a little bit on ice cream cones too. Crackers, every time I make chili, I always seem to not have the oyster crackers. But one thing I've found is that once you open the oyster crackers, they don't keep very well. So you have to find a way, whether that's sealing in a jar to keep them fresh. So just different types of crackers. And these are more like the, not the expensive crackers that you serve with a charcuterie. These are more just regular crackers. The ones I use for charcuterie, I usually buy those right before I put a charcuterie board together. And I mentioned that because I do have a video later in this series where we did a charcuterie grazing table for 30 people. Okay, and then again, my spray cheese, I absolutely love it. I shouldn't have apologized earlier because no apologies here. It's just like that and chicken in a biscuit crackers. That's like my moment of this, you know, I was rewarded for something. And that's how I reward myself. Okay, I'll take this one out. See, and the reason I also like this bin is it's lighter. It has handles like this. So think about that versus a fabric bin or ones without handles or, you know, something that's not going to be easy for you to lift out because you are standing up here if you're going to go all the way to the ceiling. All right, I have one more thing, which is extra hot horseradish. And that's going to go with the pickled and peppers because it's in a little jar. It's, you know, I just think of it as hot. And by the way, I learned this new recipe for make your own shrimp cocktail sauce or cocktail sauce using horseradish. I didn't realize how easy it is. Or so if I don't want it standing up like that, I can always lay it down. So I put the boxes in the recycling, put the towels back, put the ladder back. And this is all done. If you want to see how I store my drinking water, click the next video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.